So, tell us about how you're involved in the community and everything.
Let me see. I play golf. Kind of a big deal. And then on all honors classes, you might run into me. I'm part of Northwoods Community Church in Peoria. I am part of Young Life. Part of a few clubs here and there, like Student Council and Junior Exec Board. And I live in Washington, Illinois.
So tell us about your life before Christ.
Well, my life before Christ definitely was a journey that I had no idea what I was signing up for. And if I had to go back, I'd still have no idea what I was signing up for, but I would still definitely do it. My journey definitely started with me in seventh grade. And this is when I started attending this thing called Wildlife. It was this organization, which is really awesome. It's affiliated with Young Life, and it was to give grade schoolers an opportunity to learn about this guy named Jesus Christ. And that's not the reason I went. I went because my friends went, and I learned, heard it made you happy, and I just wanted to be happy. I mean, you'd wonder why I would say that, because when I was in grade school, I mean, I was a state athlete in the 4x2 and the 4x4, and I went to state in high jump as well, and I got a few academic awards across the board for being decently intelligent. And you'd think that I had it all, and I didn't. I definitely was, definitely had different motives for those things. The reason that I did track is because I had a really, really bad acne during that time, and to make myself cope, I knew that exercise and running would help the situation. So I ran. I pushed myself way past my limits, and just so that maybe my skin would look a little better, I dieted. I
didn't eat enough food a few times because research made it sound like you eat bad, you are what you eat. So I didn't want to, I was very so much about my identity and how I looked. And then I used to yell at God about it. I was like, why God? Why me? Why this kid? And there was a lot of times I would lay in bed at night after hanging out with friends and noticing that people noticed how bad my acne was. And I was really suicidal. I definitely had thoughts about killing myself because I just felt like I was ugly and unwanted. And I blamed God. Why in the world would God do this to a kid like me? What did I do to him? And then another aspect was my education. I was hoping that maybe people would look more deeper than the skin level and look on the inside. And so I really, really tried hard in school, even to the point that I would frustrate myself because I wasn't one of the smartest, because I wanted people to realize that I was so intelligent on the inside that they would make up for my outward appearance. And during this whole time, I had the opportunity to go to this thing called Wildlife Camp, which was the greatest week of my life. And I had an opportunity to definitely learn a little bit more about God.
So tell us about your coming to Christ, your emotional state, and your thought processes.
When I came to Christ, my thought process was, so simple. It's not nearly as difficult as it was, but it was enough to realize that I couldn't do life on my own. Not only can I not do it on my own, but I needed something supernatural. It's like I was designed for something supernatural. Something like God. And I went to Young Life or Wildlife Camp with that mindset that I needed something. It wasn't working.
Life wasn't working. I wasn't happy. I wasn't satisfied with who I was and with the results of things that had happened. And wildlife was awesome. I had an opportunity to just run around and just forget my problems. They took your phones away. It just gave me an opportunity to just focus on my friends and really focus on what mattered in life and just have fun. And no one was judging you. And I obviously didn't want to judge people. Like, my whole mindset just made sense there. Not only did it just make sense there when we were running around, but it kept progressing throughout the week. Then we had these things called cabin time, where we'd just open up about our life. And I don't even remember what was said anymore. But I do remember it was the first time I realized the power that Jesus Christ could have in my life. Because it was the first time I really said, Jesus, I need you. I need you. I can't do it. And your love loves me. And it was during this time that I just prayed. And I said, God, I want that inside of me. And it was an opportunity that God just was waiting for. He must have been. I mean, just the feeling of satisfaction that just flowed through me. And the feeling of peace and not having to live up to the world's expectations just melted. And I took a prayer after that, or I did a prayer after that. It was mostly silence. I didn't know what to say. Kind of like I don't know how to say now. Because when I was standing in the presence of God, I realized, what's there to complain about? What has he not done for me? And after that, accepting Christ, when I came home, I obviously had some changes that needed to take place. If I wanted to keep Jesus Christ as the center of my life, and it involved moving away from some friends that weren't so on fire for God, and my alternative was no friends, and I'm so glad I chose no friends for that period of time. Time to reflect. Time, not only was it a time to just be bored out of my mind because I had nothing to do, but God enabled me. It's like, this isn't supposed to be a sad time. You know that family that you haven't been spending time with? Go spend time with them. And I had a great opportunity to go spend time with my family that I had so neglected. I just ran out of the house and went hanging out with friends. No time between to talk to my parents, ask them how life was, ask them for questions, ask them for guidance. And now I had an endless amount of time just to talk to them and see why they made the choices they did. And it just grew my faith. I was blessed in a Christian household, but you know what? I never took advantage of it until after I truly realized what it was like to follow Christ. But even in that time that might seem like pain and suffering, when I focused my thoughts on Christ, it was still the greatest thing I ever did.
Tell us about your life with Christ.
My life with Christ has been absolutely I don't even know how to describe it. Besides peace, patience, learning, waiting, love, joy. And the reason that I say all these great things is because even when I went through painful times, as long as I have focused my attention on the one who mattered, it didn't really matter. The pains in this life that have been dealt to me, they just seem to vaporize when I focus my attention on God. And
besides trials, I've had great opportunities to reach out to other people about this confident decision that I made to follow Jesus. And what I love about Jesus is the more you research about him, the more confident you'll be. Because science proves God. History proves God. Archaeology proves God. The way, just all of these questions are answered in God. And the more you search, just the more you realize how he's just everywhere. And it's a reality. It's not just a mentality. And it just, I'm fortunately complimented by many people for my faith. And I gotta thank God for faith, because obviously faith is something that I can't just grow on my own. It's something that God has blessed me with. But God sure does make it. He sure does make it following him so awesome. I can't imagine putting my faith in anything else. And the opportunities that he's given me to invite people through knowing all this knowledge and just changing me as a person from being angry and so self-absorbed into I cry when I see someone else cry. I hurt when I see someone else going through a problem. I feel their pain. And the answer is always turn to God. And it never grows old. My low points is when I don't get to share the news of Jesus Christ very often. And it's the transformation you see in people's life. It confirms everything. God works. God is alive and well.
How about you tell us about some big hurdles that you've jumped with Christ's strength.
Big hurdles that I've jumped with God's strength, besides the ones I've already mentioned, would definitely be how hard I was on myself. I was just so hard on myself. I used to, when I exercised, I used to exercise until I wanted to pass out. When I did homework, I would make sure that every answer was exactly right before I even took a break. I mean, my life was perfection in my mind. I wanted it to be perfection. And I used to find my self-worth in my perfection. Until I realized how much it didn't satisfy, how much I couldn't be perfect. And then I realized that there was this guy that was perfect. And that's always where I put back my hope. Is that there was a guy that was perfect. And he told me, you don't have to be perfect, Matt. Follow me. Just follow me. So I just keep following. It doesn't really matter where I end up. As long as I'm following. Does that mean I've become like a bum and like dropped out of society? Not really. I still have great grades, but they're not the idol of my life. It didn't really matter if I had straight F's. As long as I tried my hardest and I kept following Christ in the process, I know that as long as I was glorifying Christ, life was fine.
You mentioned a highlight in your life, or your most memorable moment that you've had with God.
The I think one of the most memorable. There's so many to pick from. I think one of the most memorable moments in my life. And this is besides seeing, going to Colorado and looking at the stars and God's creation. This is besides it seeing what he's done in my own life. It always goes back to what he's done in other people's lives. And the biggest moment that I remember is when I was at Young Life Camp, or I wasn't at Young Life Camp, I was at Young Life Club, and a fellow kid from Washington named David Bowden cried out and said, "I want something different. I want something different with my life." I'll never forget that. That look of vulnerability. That look that he realized how much more there was in Christ. And just as the tears rolled down all our faces, as he wanted to redirect his life and get on the straight and narrow, it was just God's presence. And it was powerful. And it was so healing. I didn't even have really anything going wrong. But after that night, I had a lot more going right. I didn't even ride the high. I looked at it not as just an emotion, I looked at it as a fact. God changes hearts. And I don't know anybody else who can do that. And because God's changed my own heart and has changed David Bowden's heart, he can change anybody's heart. And that's another hope I hold too. My name is Matthew Fletcher from Washington, Illinois, and I am that person next door. Tonight's the night for the sinner.